Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and welcome back. Today I'm going to share with you a very beautiful and interesting sunnah. And we need to practice it quite often, not every now and then, because it is one of the very fascinating practices. The sunnah of waking up at night and waking up your wife, or the wife wakes up her husband, the spouses, in order to pray together, even if it is just two rak'ahs. So in the sound hadith, which is collected by Abu Dawood in his Sunan, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, and listen carefully to what he said. He said, رحم الله رجلا. May Allah have mercy on a man who wakes up at night to pray. فأيقظ أهله. And then he tries to awaken his wife. And if she refuses, or if she's too sleepy, نضح في وجهها الماء. He would simply wet his fingers and sprinkle some water over her face. Not shower her with water. Not pour a bucket of water over her face. It's simply want to do something beautiful. So I don't want you to be missing in action. I want to be with me. Why? Because the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, رحم الله, may Allah have mercy on. Is this something to be missed? Wallahi, may Allah have mercy on the person who will do this, who will get up at night to pray. Did he say how many rak'ahs? Did he say a long tahajjud? Did he say you recite Surah Al-Baqarah? None of the above. He said, may Allah have mercy on a man who wakes up at night to pray. Then he awakens his wife. If she's too sleepy, he would wet his fingers, sprinkle some water over her face until she wakes up to pray with him. وَرَحِمَ اللَّهُ امْرَأَةً. And may Allah have mercy on a woman. Again, who would wake up at night to pray. And instead of praying by herself, honey, get up, lead me in the night prayer. And if he's too sleepy, she will do the same. Wet her fingers, sprinkle some water over his face. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in another hadith, which is narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, and it is a sound hadith, I would consider it complementary to this hadith. If a man and a woman, if the husband and wife get up at night to pray, even two rak'ahs. Imagine if you recite in the first rak'ah, Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar, very brief surah. إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَثَرَ فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرُ 3 verses. And in the second rak'ah, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ 4 verses. So the entire prayer would be less than 5 minutes. If a man and his wife get up at night to pray, the night prayer, tahajjud, even if it is 2 rak'ahs, كُتِبَ جَمِيعًا مِنَ الذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ. The Almighty Allah will record the names during that night among the list of those who remember Allah much, men and women. And so what? Yeah, so what? In Surah Al-Ahzab, there is a beautiful ayah. It's a long ayah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. To the end of the traits of the believing men and women, والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات. And those who remember Allah much, men and women. أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. Indeed, Allah has prepared for them مغفرة, forgiveness. وأجرا عظيما, and a great reward. So that can be achieved simply by you and your spouse waking up at night every now and then. Why not on a regular basis? Pray just 2 rak'ahs. And then when you get used to it, make them 4, make them 6, make them 8. Qiyamul layli sharaful mu'min. It is the honor of a believer to pray at night. Then remember what we said in the first hadith, رحم الله. So you will be eligible for Allah's mercy. May Allah have mercy on all of us and grant us the greatest conclusion to our lives. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.